babes, it's Beth here. I'm doing something that I haven't done yet. I'm kind of surprised I haven't done it yet, which is just take a video on my phone when I'm at the beach and when I'm out about doing my daily thing. Because it's such a beautiful lifestyle that I have, and I'd love to share it with you. Just like, I just get so inspired by where I am and what I'm doing. So, I'm on the beach. I'll do a little panorama for you girls to see what it looks like. There's so many people on the beach right now for Tofino. Tourist season. It's a pretty full one. Okay, so this video is just for you ladies who are in this group, Angel Coaching with Beth Catherine. That's the only place I'm going to post it because I find it's such an intimate place where I like really get a feel for who I'm speaking to. It's really nice. So, as you know, I came back from a music festival from the weekend, and I just had such a crazy experience. So, so beautiful. It was called the Atmosphere Gathering. It was on Vancouver Island in Canada, in Comox Valley, and it was just a really conscious festival, really conscious celebration. It was fairly small. Rising Appalachia and Naco Bear and Medicine for the People played, a couple of the bigger names you might know of. But it was just really cool. DJs, music, workshops, medicinal mushroom workshops. This incredible teepee was set up. We did a cacao ceremony of healing with the masculine and feminine. There was an elixir bar, superfoods, amazing vendors who just sold like elf clothing. And everybody there was just so expressing themselves and so in a space of love for one another. Like looking around at all of these such beautiful people. Like there was no energy of like, oh fuck, like she's so beautiful and like I want to be like her and I'm jealous. It was just like, oh my god, you're so beautiful. Thank you for being beautiful. I'm beautiful. You're beautiful. Let's celebrate. It was just wonderful. And I was just dancing so much. And then in the middle day, I took LSD for my third time. I've only tried it for the first time like a few months ago. And I have a really, like, so far I've had a really profound experience and relationship with LSD. And I ended up taking a decent amount, more than I thought that I was. And it came to me in a really, really beautiful way. And I totally treat these psychedelics like medicine and like a conscious communion with the universe. And I think a lot of you kind of agree or are on the same page with that. And and I've like never talked about doing like psychedelics or anything online before, but like I said, this group feels like really supportive and awesome, so I'm super excited to just share what really happens in my life. And I had this moment, so I was coming up on this medicine, and I walked over Autumn Sky, visionary artist, and a friend of mine, so beautiful, and her partner were painting this angel. It was like, they were creating this masterpiece, like insane, like huge angel in a matter of hours. And when I connected with it, I felt like the angel was like going in and out and in and out and moving, and it was Archangel Raphael, and it was speaking to me through this painting and just like blasting my heart with this energy. And I just started weeping. I was just like staring. I was like in the middle of this festival just like weeping. I was like, I don't think anyone notices me, but I'm just gonna weep anyway. And then it just got so intense that I had to go to the porta potties and just be like just so weeping. And I saw the ancestors of our sisters like dancing around us, and the porta potty was like, even though it's plastic and we would think of it as this very like man-made thing, what was happening is I was seeing the ancestors of our sisters, especially First Nations sisters who had really been celebrating that day, just like dancing in the porta potty. And their message was, everything is made of your ancestors, like everything, like even this plastic is made from oil, and oil is like bones and carbon that's been degrading for a really long time. So literally the porta potty is actually made of our ancestors, like the animals, the bones, of trees, of people that have passed. And then I just went out into the world and just had the best time ever. And there was so much that happened during that experience. But I just wanted to share with you like the main message. Like there are so many beautiful parts of it, but there was really one concrete main message that came out of my experience. And I'm going to keep talking about it. I'm going to keep, like, I just feel like such a deep message was delivered to me and through me that I'm just so excited to keep telling people about it. And the message is, you've heard it before, but I just want to say it in another way, like, and just like see how deep we can go with really understanding this, which is, you are so loved, like so beautiful, so incredibly loved, and the worst thing that your soul has ever done, like the worst things that you could possibly remember doing, whether it's from past lives or this lives, whether it's stealing, murdering, raping, killing, you know, we think about crazy things like the Holocaust, things like that. It doesn't matter. The worst thing that your soul has ever done, Kali is who I was, who was, came to me. Kali and like the universe, it's just they laugh in its face. It's nothing. Like the worst thing. Like I kept being like just dancing, and through me she'd go, give me worse. Like nothing. There's nothing that you could do that would make me not love you. And it wasn't even about, I was saying this experience to a girlfriend. She's like, forgiveness. And I said, no, it wasn't even forgiveness. There was nothing to forgive. There's nothing to forgive. It's just you're like perfect and magnificent, and you never did anything wrong. And those things that you maybe hold, so let's bring it into today and right now, the places that you're uncomfortable in your body or uncomfortable in your skin are pretty much from, like from what I can see, you being uncomfortable with yourself in some way. And the only reason that we be uncomfortable with ourselves is that we feel like we've done something wrong, or we're not okay, or we don't quite measure up. And all that's just like bullshit. It's funny. In terms of like the universe and how it views it, I think it's funny, and it's well, it's like there's compassion there, but it's just like, no, like that's not even real. Like that's just not even who you are. Like you're so cool and so awesome. And so I want you to know that, and I also want to kind of inspire you, or like suggest or encourage you, I think that's the word I'm looking for, encourage you to be more expressive with your truth and your creativity in your everyday lives. So let's, you know, moving on from that truth of you're so loved, okay, if you're so loved and there's nothing wrong that you can do, then why don't you just shout your truth from the rooftops? Why don't you dance in the streets? Why don't you sing? Why don't you tell that person that they have a beautiful soul? Why don't you, you know, touch somebody if you feel like touching them? Why don't you create that piece of art if that's coming through you? Why don't you start just like singing for no reason and channeling? Why don't you start that blog that you've been wanting? Whatever it is, I don't care. As long as it feels good, do whatever feels good that's flowing through you to do. Because I work with, like, there's this, yeah, I've connected with you. I was going to say, oh, I work with a lot of you, but I feel like I know more and more who I'm talking to now with this group open. So with you, beautiful woman that I've been connecting with over the last couple weeks, what I see, there's a lot of different questions that come, and they're all sort of about different things, but, and I'm really happy to speak to those individual situations because there's specific lessons that can come from them. But overall, what I see is just a need. It would be easier for everybody, for all of us, to live this human life in its challenging ways if we felt that pull and that call to just unapologetically love ourselves from so deep. So that's what I was speaking of, that main message. And so much easier if we then express the truth that comes from that. So first, just, oh my God, I love myself. I'm ready to do that. I'm going to affirm. I'm going to write in my journal. I'm going to meditate on how much I love myself. I'm going to give myself permission. And then just express that. And it really simplifies life a lot. Because a lot of the questions that I get are related to the future or relationships. And in some way, there's always a tinge of, this isn't good enough, or I'm not good enough. How can I be better, or how can this be better? And it really, living in the way of when you just understand, oh my God, I'm so good, I'm so right, and I can express that now. It really simplifies a lot of this stuff. It makes the future sort of irrelevant because you're creating in the now, and you know that you don't need anything from the future because you have it right now. And although we can be excited for the future, sure, but yeah, it just really simplifies it and brings it back. So I'm excited to keep talking to you and keep sort of delivering these messages that I'm getting in different ways. I just want to express, too, that on my path I've really questioned whether any of this stuff works. This stuff works, right? And I think a lot of you have been in similar positions where you're just like, okay, like there are certain times that I do feel it, but I wonder, like, is this, like I'm meditating and like I'm praying and I'm asking and, but I don't know if I'm really seeing it or feeling the difference. You know, does any of this stuff work? Is it real? You know, are other people right? Is the rest of the world right when they say magic isn't real? You know, let's give up on spirituality. Let's give up on what's out there. And, like, I feel really happy to be in this position that I am now. And I've been pretty devoted to my practice and my path for about 5 years now. And it's a whole lifetime journey. Our path starts when we're we're human pastors when we're born, right? But really, like, I've been really meditating and really connecting and really, like, wanting to find out the truth for about 5 years now. And I will tell you that this stuff works. I am in definitely a completely different place than I ever have been. It's just so amazing how much magic is real. And, like, I'll even give you an example. When I was at the festival, I was just walking along. There's people everywhere and lots of loud music and things. And there's this bird, like a small bird, this big, that just started following me. It was, like, walking along. I saw it, and then I walked along with it. And it followed me, this bird, right by my feet, like, walking, not flying. When there's all these other people there, and usually birds get the fuck out of there when there's a lot of commotion. It was, like, following me for, like, 5 minutes, just, like, and flying when he was, like, too slow, like, flying right to my feet to get me. And everyone was, like, looking, and I was just, like, I felt so much magic in my heart. Like, I knew what this bird was doing, just, like, wanted to be near me. I was, like, oh, my God. It was, like, one of the most magical experiences of my life. Like, magic is real, and feeling better and better and more connected is real. And wherever you are on your path is, like, so perfect, because you can't fuck it up. You just can't fuck it up. And I'm excited to keep growing with you and learning with you. If any of you are feeling kind of, like, weird right now, because I'm sensing, like, people watching this later, and I, like, sense of, like, a few vibes are just, like, a little bit, yeah. Just call your ego out. If it doesn't feel good, be like, yo, ego, what up? What up? I'm gonna act, but, like, what up? Like, thank you for being here, but, like, I choose in my truth to listen to this message. And your ego, our ego's always, or not always, but they can definitely tend to flare up when we hear truth. You know, the ego's mission is basically to tell us that we're not good enough and we need to be better. So when I come on video and I'm like, hey, like, there's actually absolutely nothing wrong with you, you've never done anything, better believe that in some cases, for some people, that ego is gonna pop up and be like, no, that's a lie. So be really mindful of that right now. In your aura and your feel, just be like, okay, what's really real? What's good? What feels good? What feels right? Breathe through it. Send it love. Send that, you know, energy that doesn't feel so great, that's just releasing itself, some white light. Visualize it. And I will be here holding the space for you, knowing that you're so lovable. Even with the ego. I have an ego too. It's pretty loud sometimes. I'll be holding the space for you. We'll be holding the space for each other as women, as we grow, as we work out the kinks, as we remember who we really are, and as we really get to work on this mission that's so sacred that we all have, that we all share, especially those of us who are attracted to this tribe. Just to really spread the love and bring it. Almost to 13 minutes. Oh, she's the goddess number. So I'm going to leave it there with you. Much love. Many blessings. You're so amazing. And keep bringing the questions, the comments. Please comment below this video if you'd like to connect, have something, an aha moment. Yeah, just comment under this video. I would love to hear from you, because it's great to talk and teach, but it's really nice to receive, you know, connection and feedback and conversation too. So just comment on this video with whatever. If you like my eye jewels, say I like your eye jewels. If you had a great experience of connecting, say that. If you're like, I don't know what you're saying, say that. Love you guys. I'll see you later.